quiet of your heart, you say, I am a God. I sit on the throne of a God in the heart of the seas. But you are a mere mortal and not a God, though you think you are as wise as a God. By your wisdom and understanding, you have gained wealth for yourself and amassed gold and silver in your treasures. By your great skill and training, you have increased your wealth. And because of your wealth, your heart has grown proud. Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Because you think you are wise and as wise as a God, I am going to bring foreigners against you, the most ruthless of nations. They will draw their swords against your beauty and wisdom and pierce your shining splendor. They will bring you down to the pit, and you will die a violent death in the heart of the sea. You were the seal of perfection, full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. You were in Eden, the garden of God. Every precious stone adorned you. Your settings and mountains were made of gold. On the day you were created, they were prepared. You were anointed as guardian cherub, for so I ordained you. You were on the holy mount of God. You walked among the fiery stones. You were blameless in your ways from the day you were created until wickedness was found in you. Through your widespread trade, you were filled with violence and you sinned. So I drove you in disgrace from the mount of God and I expelled you. Your heart became proud on account of your beauty, and you corrupted your wisdom because of your splendor. So I threw you to the earth. I made a spectacle of you before kings. By your many sins and dishonest trade, you have desecrated your sanctuary. So I made a fire come out from you, and it consumed you, and I reduced you to ashes on the ground in the sight of all who were watching. All the nations who knew you are appalled at you. You have come to a horrible end and will be no more. Though Satan had his way in the Garden of Eden, and as he set out to destroy all that God has planned, we find in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 20, it was foreknown before the foundation of the world, but was made manifest in the last times for the sake of us. The scripture is talking about Jesus, the Son of God. Though God knew one of his children would turn on him, God also was well prepared and would eventually send his son Jesus to earth as his final move. Friend, the production is not only about God's final move, but it is also to show you how God can redeem any one of us from our failures, iniquity, pain, depression, and hurt through his son, Jesus. Friends, tonight you will see people throughout the Bible who got it wrong, who failed, who turned from God's heart. And yet God in his grace holds his arms open wide and with his truth sets us all free.
felt shame, guilt, and fear.
I hereby confirm my covenant with you and your descendants, and with all the animals that were on the boat with you, the birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals, every living creature on earth. Yes, I am confirming my covenant with you. Never again will flood waters kill all living creatures. Never again will the flood destroy the earth. I am giving you a sign of my covenant with you and with all living creatures. For all generations to come, I have placed my rainbow in the clouds. It is a sign of my covenant with you and with all the earth. When I send clouds over the earth, the rainbow will appear in the clouds, and I will remember my covenant with you and with all living creatures. Never again will the flood waters destroy all life. When I see the rainbow in the clouds, I will remember the eternal covenant between God and every living creature on earth. Yes, this rainbow is the sign of the covenant I am confirming with all the creatures.
Thank you. Jim. Be blessed. And may Canaan be his servant. May God increase the territories of Japheth. And may Japheth share in the prosperity of Shem. And may Canaan be his servant.
So lately, God has been teaching me to be secure in my identity as a beloved daughter of God. For me, I was putting my identity in my job, what I studied, where I lived, and even my friends. It was leaving me insecure and unsure who I was. But slowly and surely, I've been learning to drink from the well of Jesus, not from what this world has to offer. Life is to be lived, and lived to the fullest. You and me, we belong here. God has a plan for every single one of us. It's just a matter of understanding and believing that He is all we need. Isaiah 41, verses 9 and 10 says this, "I have called you back from the ends of the earth, so you can serve me. For I have chosen you and will not throw you away. Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, and I will uphold you with my victorious hand." The world is a confusing and chaotic place, but we've just got to remember that God's right there. He's standing there with his arms wide open, waiting for us to run to Him and let Him love us in the place of fear and rejection. My identity, it's now in Him and Him alone.
Thank you. sorry excuse for you. I guess I've ever seen you. Wait, I've seen more, and you're one of them! This is it, Jonah. I'm gonna stop being good now. There is no forgiveness for me. You screwed up, Jonah. Where is your God? What can he do now? You've gone too far, too deep, and too low. Not even your God can see you now. You're mine, Jonah. And there's no turning back from this.
If I can get people to turn away from God, then they are useless.
people actually believe my lies? That God is all about himself and that I'm for them? As long as they continue to believe my lies, then I've done my job.
Neglect, emotional and mental abuse, feeling alone, no one cares, selfish, self-centered, hate and uncontrol. What do these words mean? My name is Gemma Ford, and all these words I just spoke of are words that played a part of my life in the last 20 years. Neglected from family, emotionally and mentally abused, I always felt alone and like no one cared. I lived to survive in this world, and my only purpose to live was for my son. 2016, I fell sick, depressed, and I had suicidal thoughts. I gave up.
Joab, greetings from your king. The bearer of this letter is Uriah, your lieutenant. With respect to Uriah, place him in the hottest part of the battle, where he is most likely to be killed.
How could our king do that? How can he be a man after God's heart?
can an act like this ever be forgiven?
Once again, men are so weak and easily swayed. Put a beautiful woman in front of them and they cave in. The lust of the flesh is something that I do very well. It's amazing how the eye can lead the heart astray. A man after God's heart.
saved others, didn't save himself if he really is God's son.
Yeah.
The chosen one.
If you really are king of the Jews, save yourself.
Elohim! Elohim! You are Sabata! My God! Why have you abandoned me?
Look at you now. You said you were going to destroy the temple and recall on a free day. You got a son of God. Come down from the cross.
Wait! Let's see if Elijah comes to save you.
Father! Father! I'm going to trust my spirit into your head!
Thank you. Jesus go to the cross and pay the ultimate price. Friends, throughout this whole production, you've seen just a glimpse of so many people within the Bible, and you've heard from friends like Sarah and Gemma sharing their testimony about who they used to be pre-Jesus until they found their relationship with Him. And can I say, it is a relationship, not a religion. I serve a religious God. I serve one that is now free, one that is alive. You see lives that have been transformed. See all these people here on the platform here, and I'm sure there's many people in this auditorium tonight that could vouch for the power of Jesus Christ. I wonder if there's any unashamed people about the love of Jesus Christ in this place. Would you just lift up your voice and give Him a 3-second shout?
Into the big world, and it won't be as hard.
didn't say it was going to be easy, but it will be easier with Jesus. So can I ask you to do one thing? You know, I don't want to scare you, friend. I ain't going to do no icky, spooky, spooky, voodoo kind of thing on you. I just want to give you an opportunity to actually receive what Jesus did on the cross. So could I ask all over the auditorium for every eye to be closed and every head to be bowed? And friend, I'm going to give you an opportunity to respond to that. Nobody looking to the left or right, because God will be speaking to somebody tonight. Maybe you're here and you're that person. Maybe you can relate to some of the characters in this production. Maybe you can relate to how the enemy has tried to get around your life and try to suck the life out of you. Maybe you can relate to Gemma and to Sarah about their testimonies of being insecure, not having an identity, not knowing who you are, struggling with fear, rejection, a whole lot of other things. Maybe you're here tonight and you have that. Maybe you've never, never asked Jesus to come into your life, into relationship with you. Well, tonight, friend, I want to give you that opportunity. I'm going to come to free, and I want you to throw your hand up. Like I said, every head is bowed, every eye is closed. Nobody looking to the left or right. This is just between them and our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to come to free, and I want you to throw your hand up. One, He is the one true God. There is no other God but Him. He is the Redeemer. He is our Provider. He is our Savior. There is only one true God. Two, it takes two people to make this decision, and Jesus made His decision by going to the cross. For your life, for your sin, for your iniquity, for your hatred, for everything that you have carried in your life, He went to the cross. And all it now takes is the second person, that is you, friend, to respond to that. Three, right now, would you bring brave and courage? As I see this hand right here. Come on. Is there anyone else to see this hand right here? Or is there anyone else to get to the house by talking for a little bit?
Transaction that happened tonight was a real transaction, and that you
you are now going with them. And Lord, some of these people are going into some hardship. I'm praying, Lord Father, would you give them strength and courage? Would you give them your mind and by your spirit would you help them to become more who you've called them to be? Lord, I pray, bless every single person in this room. In Jesus' name. Can we just worship one more time? Is that alright? Is that alright with you? Inspired and branched just together. You're all welcome to come today. But God bless you all. Have a fantastic day.